Hello, my name is Pawan Khandavilli, and I'm a product manager for the Azure Conferential Computing team. Today, I'll be talking to you about our latest innovation in conferential computing, which is conferential containers on Azure container instances. Before we head into the actual topic, I just want to give a brief overview of the spectrum of offerings that we have in conferential computing at Azure. Towards the left-hand side, we have conferential VMs and AKS node pools that are easier to onboard legacy apps and have a largest trust boundary. And as we move towards the right, to the extreme right, we have VMs with app enclaves that are custom solutions that provide granular security control. Conferential containers provide a more balanced approach for building conferential workloads on the cloud. And today we'll be concentrating on conferential containers and ACI. What are the goals of conferential containers? To run a container, we need a stack of software and hardware. On the right, we have a representation of how it might look in a cloud environment, which has the hypervisor, the host OS, the runtime, and containers and the variety of configurations that the containers come with. So we have the need for sandboxing and isolation, full configuration, and also the remote attestation of this trusted compute base. We need the container launch and the configuration of this container workload to be immutable after launch, and also having a transparent and audible trusted computing base. Some of the customer motivations that we have encountered while building conferential containers. Containerized workloads are becoming the norm for running applications in a cloud-native manner. Defense and depth has become increasingly important during scenarios where cybersecurity threats are increasing. Zero trust for applications that deal with multi-party computation data, as well as collaborative applications such as data clean rooms, is a must for organizations as they are embarking on these new business models. Sandboxing and isolation of these containers reduces the attack surface of these containers, which has become increasingly important. And customers are also looking for full attestation of the container group and the containers that are running within it, along with the ability to lift and shift their containers without having a lot of code and development programming model changes. Azure Container Instances is a serverless container service that allows users to run containerized applications in the Azure cloud without having to manage any underlying infrastructure. It is the fastest and easiest way to deploy a container in the cloud with the flexibility of resource allocation and cost effectiveness. ACI provides per second billing, allowing users to optimize costs by only paying for the exact usage of the containers with no upfront costs or management overheads. We've built upon this innovation of ACI, and now we have the offering of conferential containers on ACI. With this model, customers can lift and shift their existing containers while receiving the additional benefits of confidentiality, which includes in-memory encryption and the attestation. Every container group is already isolated by the hypervisor, but now we have the addition of hardware-based memory encryption with a key per container group powered by the latest AMD SEV-SNP hardware. We have also introduced the notion of an attestable execution policy that constrains what can be run in this environment. And we have also provided open source integrated remote attestation and other conferential primitive sidecars such as secure key release that enable users to build in these confidential computing features more easily into their software. A look at the deployment experience here. You have an ARM template that defines the properties of a trusted execution environment. And then we have introduced a tool called ConfCom that takes in this ARM templates and calculates a fully auditable policy that can be included in the ARM template during the deployment time. And this gets deployed into the container group. So a quick visual of what I've just discussed, we've introduced the confidential SKU into the ACI product and the confidential computing property that enforces what can be run within a container group is included as part of the deployment template. A bit of a deeper dive into the execution policy, which we call it the confidential computing enforcement policy. These are a core feature of the architecture of our confidential containers. And the CC policy is created during deployment time and embedded into the template and provides full visibility of what is running inside a container group. This policy is then enforced by the guest agent inside the container group, and the policy defines the constraints such as what are the images, what are the environment variables, and privileges that a container can have within this container group. So how exactly do we establish this trust during launch? So the hardware, in this case, the AMD SEV-SNP hardware, measures the software stack that is being booted up in the container group, and it also captures the hash of the security policy from the deployment template, embeds it as an immutable field in the container group, which is immutable throughout the lifecycle of the container group. The guest agent enforces the policy inside the container group. So this establishes trust during launch. But how does a user verify that they're actually talking to a container group that they intend to? So you can, software running inside the container group can request the hardware for an attestation evidence. This attestation evidence includes the measurements of the container group itself, along with the security policy, which is being enforced in the container group. Relying parties can use services such as our Microsoft Azure attestation, as well as other attestation services, to verify that they're indeed talking to trusted hardware with the expected execution policy that is embedded in the host data field. As mentioned before, we have open source confidential sidecars that enable users to build in these confidential computing primitives, such as attestation, secure key release with Azure Key Vault, and also provide an encrypted file system. Customers can use this to build in these primitives into their applications, and they're available at the link below. So for the demo, we will cover two containers. So one is a sum container that calculates the sum of two numbers. It's a simple container, and a product container that calculates the product of two numbers. And this we deem as the malicious behavior for the purposes of this demo. So we're going through the deployment scenario. How do we take this sum container and deploy it into the Azure container instances with execution policy? And in the second scenario, we're going to replace this container with a product container that essentially will cause a deployment failure because it does not adhere to the policy that was calculated. And then in the third step, we're going to detect that even if a user is able to deploy the product container, how we can use the measurements and remote attestation to reflect these changes to detect that this is not the workload that we are supposed to talk to. And finally, we'll also show that we are going to deny an interactive shell into the container, which will disallow any admin to be able to shell into the container and see the data that is being processed in memory. So let's go to the demo. So for the demo, we are going to use a Python notebook to drive it. And as mentioned, we have two containers, sum and product. In the first step, I'm going to build the sum container and upload it to the container registry. Once I've done that, I'm going to generate the security policy as discussed in the previous slides. This is something that is enforced by the container group. We have the platform sidecar that performs the attestation, as well as the sum container being deployed as part of this ARM template. We have the SKU set as confidential. And once I run the tooling on this ARM template, the tooling will have the hash of the security policy presented here, and embed the base 64 security policy that we discussed as part of the ARM template. And now this ARM template is ready to be deployed. So in this next step, I'm going to deploy this to a container group on ACI. Now that we have successfully deployed, we go to the portal to verify that it has been deployed. And then we need the public IP to retrieve the attestation. I'm going to copy the public IP of this container group from the portal, and I'm going to inject that into my script here that will get the attestation token and verify that the host data is what is expected. So when I run this part of code, we get the Microsoft Azure attestation token. It's a valid token, and we see that the host data, which is part of the attestation, is the same as what we have calculated during deployment time. So in this next step, we're going to show the error scenario. Before that, we need to stop the container group, and I'll explain this as we go further in the demo. So we are stopping the container group that we just deployed. And what we're going to do is we are going to replace the sum container with the product container that we have that essentially reverses the operation that is being done. So we have now pushed the product container to the same tag as the sum container. And what we're going to do now is we're going to restart the container group. During this step, the ACI control plane will try to pull the latest container, which is the product container. But this deployment will fail because the measurements of the product container are not the same as the sum container, and that will be detected by our policy during initialization, and it will fail the container group deployment. Yeah. So now we see that the device hash does not match and has not been found. So we know the container group has stopped the deployment because the policy that it expected was of the sum, but the container that was trying to be booted up was the product. So next we're going to emulate, let's say there's a malicious admin who's able to deploy the product container by going through the different steps. So they calculated the hash of the security policy, and then they're going to deploy this container group with the right policy. So this time we won't see a failure of the deployment, but then when we check the attestation token, we see that the measurement was not what was calculated for the sum, and we can detect that as part of the remote attestation. So we've successfully deployed the product container group, and we'll go to the Azure portal and pick up the public IP, similar to what we have done for the previous container group. We have the IP address here, and we are copying it and going to inject it into the script. So what this will do is, even though we have deployed the product container, we can verify that the remote attestation is not the same. The measurements of the host data and the remote attestation is not the same as what was calculated for the sum container, so the host is not trusted in this scenario. And as the last step of the process, we are going to try and execute into the container group. So I'm going to the text product container, and I'm going to try through the portal to execute into it using SSH, and we get an error saying that the execution has failed because it has been denied by policy. So in this demo, we have seen that the container group enforces the policy that is being measured during deployment time. And we know that what is running inside your container group is what is expected. Thank you so much for joining us today on a discussion on conferential containers on Azure Container Instances. To learn further about conferential ACI, and our other innovative offerings from Azure Conferential Computing, and also learn about how our customers are using our innovations in their products, please refer to the links below.